Anyone who watches this program knows that you've been up in arms about cop killer Herman Bell being let off on parole. He ambushed two New York police officers, and now there is another one who was charged in that same crime who is also up for parole.
Anthony Bottom. Washington, it was three people involved here. Washington died in prison.
Right.
They released Bell about a month and a half ago. And now Anthony Bottom is coming up for parole. Now, these three individuals drew these two police officers into the Harlem houses and under false pretenses, and then they shot. Waverly Jones was killed instantly, and Herman Bell went on to shoot, and so did Anthony Bottom, Joseph Piergiottini. Joseph Piergiottini begged for his life, begged for his wife, for his daughters, please, 22 times. And then they shot him in the head to kill him at the end. These animals do not belong on the streets of the city of New York. They belong in jail. This went into effect, unfortunately, new laws went into effect, 25 to life, after these individuals were sentenced. Had that been in effect, then these animals would not be walking the streets of the city of New York. Bell is out there. He's living in Brooklyn. Think about that. Here's a guy, who's he living next to? What community is he in? This is just plain wrong. Who is going to be the next family impacted by these radical individuals that still have their radical beliefs? Because we know that, because they've erased their Twitter, and in their Twitter that we have some screenshots of, that show that their radical beliefs and the radicalism is still very much alive
in them. How are they even allowed to have Twitter?
They got everything. They live in a lot better than people think. And right now, they're about to be, the last person is Anthony Bottom to be released. Now, you gotta remember, they also killed the third cop in San Francisco. So we know, this is that we know of, we know that they killed three police officers. Had they killed more? Had they wounded more? Had they been, in the book that's out there, it actually shows how they were instrumental in bringing explosives to a precinct. They were going to blow this precinct up. They had dynamite. They had all access to high chemicals that would have decimated. And that's when they shot that sergeant in San Diego and killed him. This is very, very, very bad people that we're about to put back on the streets. And they did the same thing with this guy, Russos, that killed the state trooper. They released him about 4 months ago. What are they sending? What message is this parole board sending to the people of our communities, the people, the families that live in these communities? What message are you sending putting these animals on the street? It's wrong. They belong in jail. They should stay in jail. They should not be released. And to put them on the street, they will be the next individual at some point down the road. They're going to hurt, maim, or kill some innocent family that's in their communities for no good reason. They should have never, ever been released. And hopefully, hopefully, this parole board does not release Anthony Bottom. And that's why we have a,
petition.
A petition that will stop Anthony Bottom from being released. And hopefully the people in our communities will sign this petition and will get behind this petition, and it will stop him from being released. This parole board was changed 4 days before Bell was released. Four days before Bell's release, they reconstituted this panel. And I guess they reconstituted this panel to get the results of what they wanted to get, and that's freeing Herman Bell. So now we got to hope that this panel that's going to do Anthony Bottom will not do the same thing.
Would it be the same panel or?
No, they changed the panel. It's a new panel. It's a different panel. But the way they changed the panel for Bell is not the way they would do it under a normal setting. They actually went out of the criteria of who would be the next to go into that panel. They did that for a reason. And I believe that commission should not be there. I believe that there are some of these members, and from now on going forward, we're going to make sure that they come before the Senate hearing and that we understand what their backgrounds are. We want to know what the release rates are. We want to know where they what they're doing, and we want to know when the individuals are coming up for parole. So that, and we want standing. We want people to be able to have standing that you can turn and bring as a community group, and have standing before that panel and go in there and talk to that panel. We want the family members to be able to plead their case. When you see that human. That human touch that's inside that panel, and you're talking about your mother, your father, your son, your daughter, I think that brings a different perspective to releasing these individuals to the streets. So we have bills that would allow that. Myself, Pat Gallivan, Senator Andy Lanza, we all have good bills that would allow the or change the dynamics of the parole board and get us the what I believe is a much fairer approach to the hearings by these parole members.
Mm-hmm. And do you think the Assembly will pass this?
The Assembly is always difficult, but I think these are simple bills.
Right.
These are not difficult bills. This is not increasing penalties. What this is just, listen, let's, if mother, the father, the child, right. the daughter, they want to try to make a plea to the panel, they should be able to do that. You can't do that today. You should be, if you're a group that's from within the community, that church group or some other group or a police group, you should be allowed to turn around to petition this panel not to release this individual. You can't do that today. We should change that. We should make it possible for these groups to do that and do the right thing for the citizenry of this great state.
All right. So that petition you were talking about is on all your social media
yes,
and
it
your
is.
Website, golden.nysenate.gov.